was just getting started at 45. I just became a grandmother. It was a whole new life opened up to me, and it was shut down real fast.
Debbie came to us more than 15 years ago with a very weak heart. This came from a pretty rare non-malignant tumor. It's called pheochromocytoma.
My heart went into cardiac arrest. I actually died three times, and they brought me back, and then they put me in a medically induced coma, and I was in a coma for 2 weeks. To actually survive what I went through was like 2%.
If this were found 5 or 10 years earlier, we wouldn't even be sitting here today, because Debbie would have had that tumor removed before any of the cardiac problems came to be. I think genomic medicine will be able to make these diagnoses a lot sooner than they were in her case.
Jackson Laboratory was established in 1929 as a center for mammalian genetics. It was established at a time when genetics was just a new field. Since then, we've really expanded and contributed significantly to the understanding of the genetics and ultimately with genomics.
Genomic medicine really is using information encoded in an individual's DNA to match treatment options with patients in a very precise way.
What we're really moving towards is targeting and personalizing all the medicine tailored to the unique genetic makeup of an individual.
I think genomic medicine also holds promise for us to understand earlier diagnostics, right? So to using a patient's DNA makeup to really better understand their inherent susceptibility to disease.
Science in this day and age is really a group effort. One laboratory by itself rarely will make the major impact.
Bioscience Connecticut is essentially the foundation for what brought Jackson Labs here, and now is expanding Bioscience Connecticut into genomic medicine.
The JAX UConn collaboration for genomic medicine has great strength on both sides. I think that it will shape things here in Connecticut and for the region, if not globally, about how you can use multi-disciplines, multiple approaches, ultimately for the goal of how do we use this to improve human health, because that's really what we're here for.
We have to know more about diseases if we're going to cure them, and if we can cure them, we're going to decrease the healthcare costs. Or we have to know more about diseases to affect people's lifestyles so they can prevent themselves from having these diseases.
I'm here today for a routine ICD pacemaker checkup.
The biggest things when we check defibrillators or pacemakers is to make sure that there's no great variations in how the defibrillator's working. So everything kind of stays the same from one visit to the next, and that's how it's been with her. Everything is checking out perfectly normal. All of her numbers are exactly where they should be.
The pacemaker itself is pretty big. And my daughters say, you know, it's like a badge that you have. You survived this. You should be proud of it. I think genomics is the way it should be going. I don't want my grandchildren to end up like this. And if it's such an easy test, and if it can detect so much, why not have it?